listeners, and welcome to the second program in our series, Let's Learn Life Science, which is produced for grade 9 learners and anybody else who has an interest in the subject. My name is Jandre, and today we will learn about the breathing system. Please have a pen and notebook ready so that you can make notes of the important points. After listening to this program, you should be able to list the features of gaseous exchange surfaces in humans. Discuss the significance of these features for the maintenance of life. Discuss gaseous exchange at the alveoli. Dear learners, I want to welcome my studio guests for today, Max and Piwa. Max is a soccer coach. He established a football club and he is also a life science teacher. Piwa is a netball coach and a physical education teacher. I'm sure that our listeners are curious to hear what we will be discussing today, since we have two sports coaches in studio. Our discussion today will focus on the breathing system. The exchange of gases is a process that takes place inside our bodies without us even being aware of it. It is so much more than simply breathing in and breathing out. Max, would you like to share with us your understanding of the process of gaseous exchange?
Yes. Gaseous exchange is the delivery of oxygen from the lungs into the bloodstream and the removal of carbon dioxide from the bloodstream into the lungs. This occurs in the lungs between the alveoli and the blood vessels surrounding the alveoli. The movement of the gases happens in response to the concentration gradient that exists. Gases diffuse from where they are in high concentration to where they are in low concentration.
Based on what Max said, clearly gaseous exchange is not breathing.
Indeed, it's not. Breathing, also referred to as ventilation, happens that air can move into and out of the lungs through the nose or the mouth. This process ensures that a different concentration is created between the gases inside the alveoli and those in the blood capillaries. Thus, if you have just taken a breath, there will be more oxygen inside the alveoli and less inside the blood capillaries surrounding the alveoli. This difference in the concentration gradient will cause the oxygen that is inside the alveoli to diffuse into the blood capillaries.
This process of gaseous exchange surely requires special features because it sounds very complicated.
Sure. The breathing system, sometimes called the respiratory system, has features to make sure the gaseous exchange occurs successfully. The lungs have millions of alveoli, which create a large surface area over which gases can diffuse between the alveoli and the blood.
Just to add to what Max said, the alveoli surface walls are thin and moist to allow gases to diffuse quickly and to dissolve easily. Breathing ensures that fresh air enters the lungs, which creates this concentration gradient between the gases so that they diffuse down the concentration gradient. They also have a good blood supply close to the respiratory membranes. Gases diffuse from the alveoli into the blood down the concentration gradient. Gases are transported to and from the body cells by the red blood cells and diffuse from the blood into the alveoli.
The respiratory system consists of the nasal cavity, the pharynx, the larynx, trachea, bronchus, bronchioli, and lungs. Piwa, can you elaborate?
Yes, the nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchus, bronchioles, and lungs are protected against injury and drying out. In humans, the lungs are protected by bones and cartilage of the rib cage. Mucus protects all respiratory surfaces from drying out.
Our bodies work every moment of the day, and this work requires energy. How does the body sustain all the different processes with sufficient energy?
Yes, the energy comes from the chemical process in the cells, called the cellular respiration. In the cellular respiration, glucose is broken down to release energy and carbon dioxide. This process needs oxygen. The respiratory system exchanges gases in the lungs. Oxygen is taken in from the air by the lungs and passed into the blood by diffusion down the concentration gradient. Oxygen is then transported by the blood to the cells, where it passes into the cells by diffusion.
If you just tuned in, we're discussing gaseous exchange. We just heard that oxygen enters the lungs, where exchange happens at the alveoli, so that oxygen can be taken into the body, cells, and the blood. But I know our cells also produce waste products, and carbon dioxide is one of them. Pewa, will you please elaborate? What happens to the carbon dioxide we produce?
Yes, the carbon dioxide is passed from the body cells to the blood by diffusion. The blood transports the carbon dioxide to the lungs, where it is exhaled into the air to remove it from the body.
It sounds like a long process, but it happens in the blink of an eye.
True, it really happens fast.
Amazing.
Yeah, for us as sports coaches, it is important that athletes understand the function of their bodies and know what they should do to ensure their bodies can function at an optimal level. Proper breathing is crucial for any athlete because the function of many other essential life processes depends on it.
We have learned so much today. Let's recap the main points. Gaseous exchange is the delivery of oxygen from the lungs to the bloodstream and the removal of carbon dioxide from the bloodstream into the lungs. Gaseous exchange occurs in the lungs between the alveoli and the blood vessels surrounding the alveoli. The movement of gases happens in response to a concentration gradient that exists. Gases diffuse from where they are high in concentration to where they are low in concentration. Gases are transferred through the exchange surfaces by means of diffusion. Oxygen moves into the body cells, and carbon dioxide moves out of the body cells by gaseous exchange. The respiratory system has large surface areas to provide enough oxygen for the cells to use and to get rid of carbon dioxide that is released. The respiratory system has a good blood supply close to the respiratory membranes. Gases diffuse into the blood and are transported to and from the body cells. In cellular respiration, glucose is broken down to release energy and waste carbon dioxide. The waste carbon dioxide is passed from the body cells to the blood by gaseous exchange. The blood transports the waste carbon dioxide into the lungs, where it is exhaled into the air to get rid of it. I hope you have learned as much as I did. Here's your question for today. Explain how the following helps with gaseous exchange. A. A good blood supply. B. A thin surface. With this question, we say bye until next time. This program was written by Shiwa Kambata.
This program was brought to you by NAMCOL with funding from the Ministry of Education, Arts and Culture and the Commonwealth of Learning.